In this video, we're continuing on with the distance, rate, time, word problems worksheet on the KutaSoftware website. You can find this worksheet under the Algebra 2 section, and I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this. In this video, we'll be doing numbers 5 through 8. In number 5, it says Perry left school driving toward the lake 1 hour before Jaidee. Jaidee drove in the opposite direction, going 6 miles per hour slower than Perry, for a total of 1 hour, after which they were 174 miles apart. So let's go ahead and draw a picture. We have Perry left school and he's driving towards the lake. Jaidee's driving in the opposite direction, going 6 miles per hour slower. So if we have Perry going this way, P, and Jaidee going that way, J. What we're trying to solve for is Perry's speed, so let's call this variable X. We know that Perry left school 1 hour before Jaidee, and Jaidee traveled a total of 1 hour. Therefore, Perry traveled a total of 1 plus 1 hours. So we have 1 plus 1 hours times his speed, which is our unknown X. That's going to be his total distance traveled. We're going to add that to the total distance that Jaidee traveled, and that's going to give us the total distance they are apart, which is 174 miles. So now figuring out Jaidee's distance, she traveled for a total of 1 hour, and she went 6 miles per hour slower. So if Perry's speed is X, Jaidee's speed is going to be X minus 6. So the distance Perry traveled plus the distance Jaidee traveled will equal the total distance that they are apart, which is 174 miles. Now we're going to simplify and solve for X. 1 plus 1 equals 2, and we have 2 hours times X plus 1 hour times X minus 1 hour times 6. So 1 hour times X minus 1 hour times 6, which will give us a total of 6 miles, since speed is in miles per hour. And when you multiply 1 hour by 6 miles per hour, we get 6 miles. And that is equal to 174 miles, the total distance that they are apart. Now I'm going to combine like terms on the left-hand side of my equation. I'm going to combine 2 hours times X with 1 hour times X. And those are added together, essentially 2X plus 1X, to give me 3X, or 3 hours, times X. And we're subtracting 6 miles from that, and that's equal to 174 miles. Now I'm going to add 6 miles to both sides to get that 3 hours times X equals 174 plus 6, which is 180 miles. Then all I have to do is divide by 3 hours. X is going to be equal to 180 miles divided by 3 hours, which is 60, and that's going to be miles per hour. So 60 miles per hour is our answer in number 5. If you get confused leaving your labels within your equation, feel free to take them out of your work, but just make sure you're keeping track of them all together. Speed, we know, would be in miles per hour. Speed would not be in just hours, and it would not be in just miles. It would be in miles per hour. So we know that our answer is miles per hour. Now on to number 6. Wilbur left the hardware store and traveled toward the recycling plant at an average speed of 33 kilometers per hour. Mary left 2 hours later and traveled in the same direction, but with an average speed of 55 kilometers per hour. So the distance that Wilbur travels is going to be equal to the distance that Mary travels. How long did Wilbur travel before Mary caught up? So Wilbur's total time of travel will be a variable. Let's make this variable z. Wilbur traveled a speed of 33 kilometers per hour, and our unknown variable z is how long he traveled for. So that will give us Wilbur's distance. Mary traveled a speed of 55 kilometers per hour, and she left 2 hours after Wilbur did. So we're going to multiply that by the time that Wilbur traveled z, minus 2. since she started 2 hours after him, so her time is going to be 2 hours less. Now let's go ahead and solve. We're going to distribute 55 kilometers per hour to Z and to the 2. So we'll have the 33 kilometers per hour times Z is equal to 55 kilometers per hour times Z minus 55 kilometers per hour times 2, which is 110 kilometers. Next, we'll subtract 55 kilometers per hour times Z. You can think of this as subtracting 55Z. 33 minus 55 will give us negative 22, and that's kilometers per hour times Z, which we know is equal to negative 110 kilometers, because that's what's left on our right-hand side. Our last and final step is to divide by negative 22 kilometers per hour. When we divide by negative 22, negative 110 divided by negative 22 will give us Z, which is 5 hours. So Wilbur traveled a total of 5 hours before Mary caught up. In number 7, we have an aircraft carrier left Hawaii traveling west 7 hours before a container ship. The container ship traveled in the opposite direction, going 5 kilometers per hour slower than that aircraft carrier for a total of 6 hours, after which the ships were 540 kilometers apart. Find the aircraft carrier's speed. Let's go ahead and draw our picture. We'll have the aircraft carrier represented by this line. So this will be the aircraft carrier and the container ship headed in the opposite direction, which will be represented by this line. The aircraft carrier left 7 hours before the container ship, and the container ship traveled a total of 6 hours. So the aircraft carrier traveled 7 plus 6 hours total. And we're trying to find that aircraft carrier's speed. So let's let this variable be x. So 7 plus 6 hours times x will give us the distance that aircraft carrier traveled. We're going to add that to the distance that the container ship traveled. The container ship traveled for a total of 6 hours, and it traveled 5 kilometers per hour slower than the aircraft carrier. So that's going to be x minus 5. Since the aircraft carrier speed is x, and if you take away 5 from x, that's 5 kilometers per hour slower. So we have the distance that the aircraft carrier traveled. Adding that to the distance that the container ship traveled, we will get the total distance that they are apart, which is 540 kilometers. Now let's go ahead and solve for x. 7 plus 6 is 13, so 13 hours times x plus 6 hours times x minus 6 hours times 5 kilometers per hour. That's going to be 6 hours times x minus 30 kilometers. And that is all equal to 540 kilometers. My next step, I'm going to combine 13 hours times x, 13x, with 6 hours times x, 6x. And I'm going to combine those with addition. At the same time, I'm going to move 30 kilometers to the other side of the equation. 13 hours times x plus 6 hours times x will give me 19 hours times x, and that's equal to 540 kilometers plus 30 kilometers, which equals 570 kilometers. Next, I'll divide 19 hours on both sides to get that x, since 19 divided by 19 is 1, and 1 times x is x. That's going to be equal to 570 kilometers divided by 19 hours, which gives us 30 kilometers per hour. So the speed of the aircraft carrier is 30 kilometers per hour. And lastly in this video, number 8. A submarine left and traveled west. 3 hours later, an aircraft carrier left, traveling 3 miles per hour faster in an effort to catch up. So we know we're traveling in the same direction. After 7 hours, the aircraft carrier finally caught up, and we're finding the submarine's average speed. So let's call this average speed y. So the distance that the submarine traveled is going to be equal to the distance that the aircraft carrier traveled. The submarine traveled for 3 hours plus 7 hours. Since the aircraft carrier traveled a total of 7 hours, and the submarine had left 3 hours before that. So we'll have 3 plus 7 hours times the submarine's average speed, y, will give us distance. That's going to be equal to 7 hours, the total time that the aircraft carrier traveled, times y plus 3, since it's going 3 miles per hour faster than the submarine's average speed. So I'm going to have to distribute the 7 with addition in between those two terms and simplify to solve. 3 plus 7 gives me 10, so that's 10 hours times y, and that's equal to 7 hours times y plus 7 hours times 3 miles per hour, which is 21 miles. My next step, I'm going to subtract 7 hours times y from both sides. 10y minus 7y will give me 3y, so I have 3 hours times y, and that's equal to 7y minus 7y, which is 0, plus 21 miles. Next, I'll divide both sides by 3 hours. I'll get that y is equal to 21 miles divided by 3 hours, which is 7 miles per hour. So 7 miles per hour is my solution in number 8. And again, if you're still not comfortable with leaving the labels in the equation, go ahead and take them out. You can see that 3 plus 7 times y equals 10y, and I have 7 times y plus 7 times 3, which is 7y plus 21. Then if I subtract 7y from both sides, 10y minus 7y will give me 3y, and that's equal to 21. Then when I divide by 3, I get that y is equal to 7, which is the average speed, so that's 7 miles per hour. And with that, we wrap up this video. Join me in the next video, where I'll complete the distance, rate, time, word problem worksheet. And as always, if you found this video helpful, don't forget to subscribe and give me a thumbs up. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated. And if you have any comments, leave them below.